Now, your local weather with the KX Storm Team.
I'm Eric Furseth.
I'm Joanne Martinson-Davis, and we're with Western Plains Opera Company.
Which is January 24th, 25th, 26th.
Hey, Tom, how's the weather?
Yeah, you're probably going to be happier next weekend with the weather because it's going to be much warmer than what we've got going on right now. And thank you for doing that, Hey Tom. Let me get you caught up with what's going on. Well, this is new too. Wind chill warning, wind chill advisory. Wind chill warning is worse. Wind chill advisory, winter weather advisory, which includes blowing snow and wind chills to about 40 below. And then we have the blizzard warning with whiteout conditions and winds to around 55 miles an hour and wind chills to about 40 below. Just in the past couple of minutes, the no travel advice has expanded in the southwest. Even from what I showed you just a few minutes ago, it's expanded towards Jamestown. I-29 is closed south of Fargo. It is ice north of Fargo. And actually, it hasn't gotten as bad as it's going to get yet. We're looking southeast at Bismarck right now. And a few minutes ago, when there's a little more light in the sky, you could see the reduced visibility back there. And here it is on the radar. So you have this band of snow from about Emmons County. You see all that brown. It's not solid brown all the way up, but that's pocket of heavy snow. We've turned on the enhanced radar here, and this is a case where most of the snow is going to be to the east, the falling snow. But remember the past several days how we have all that really fresh, light, powdery snow on the ground that just blows around real easy? Well, it didn't ever warm up enough to freeze and compact. So the winds, when they really pick up tonight, are going to be blowing that all around. So we may have areas with a ground blizzard, which means blizzard conditions, but from the snow that's on the ground, not falling out of the cloud. But in the east, it is going to be real, real tough. You can even see it right here, these darker browns, all the way up through Steele, up towards Devil's Lake. The temperatures have really been plummeting. Now, we've had a northwest wind bringing that cold Canadian air in, and right ahead of it, and you can see right here, this is where that line is, and this is where the snow's falling, too. We're getting a little extra lift here as those air masses collide, but certainly warmer to the east of that, but all this cold air is going to be pushing east. So if you were thinking of traveling, temperatures are going to plummet, and the wind chills are really going to drop, and visibility be near zero, so it really is a bad situation. And you can even see the sustained winds around Highway 83 off to the west and much lighter winds to the east. Again, it hasn't gotten that bad in the east yet. Bad enough that it's already no travel advised, but it's going to get a lot worse. So here's the Cartiva Minot wind chill map, and back behind that frontal boundary, we've got wind chills already as low as 30 degrees below zero. And they could get colder. So here's our precision cast, and if you look at the wind legend here, look at these colors here. So we're looking at 25 to 30 mile an hour sustained winds, and the winds at times could gust 50 to 55 miles an hour. So here's that snow. This is the future radar. We may have some moving in tonight, and we're going to have some pretty strong winds as well. So that's that blowing snow that I was telling you about. It may not be snowing much out of the clouds early in the morning, but the snow that's on the ground is still going to be blowing around a lot. And again, these are sustained winds around 30 miles an hour. Some of the wind gusts could be 50 to 55, as I pointed out earlier. So the wind chill forecast, this is when you get up tomorrow morning. Most of the wind chills are going to be 25, 30, 35 to close to 40 degrees below zero. It is going to be that cold. And then throughout the day, it's really not going to improve a whole lot. Maybe a few degrees, but it is just going to be brutally cold during the day tomorrow. And even by tomorrow afternoon at 4 o'clock, that really isn't much of an improvement. This really is bad. So the next 72 hours for Dickinson, we're going to see some cold weather. But by Monday, look at those temperatures, probably mid-20s. And there's no minus sign in front of that either. And for Williston, we're going to be below zero, brutally cold wind chills, around 40 below. And then by Monday, again, it looks like we'll have temperatures in the upper 20s. So for tonight, these are the air temperatures, not the wind chills, and then daytime highs tomorrow. Notice how they're staying below zero, plus all that wind. It is just not going to be fun to be outdoors. So here's a look at the next 7 days. Now, once we get into Monday, 17 is probably going to feel pretty good. It will be a little bit breezy. But once we get into the middle of next week, it looks like that pattern change takes over, and then we start getting some warmer weather. But tonight and tomorrow, it's going to be brutally cold out.